Unsettled souls, and welcome to The Correct Views. Sam, I be the Gangi doing brief political commentary for the media speaks. Friends, I want to dedicate this show to my friend Cheyenne. At the end of the show, we're going to give you information on where you can donate money to a friend of mine who was a mother who was 8 months pregnant, got into a head-on collision. No, she was not drunk. She was not sighted or anything like that. Her baby lived. She did not. She's 28 years old. Her parts have been donated as she wished, and she's no longer with us. So those of you that want to help out with something that really matters, I'll give you information at the end of it. Most of you, I'm well aware of what you want. You want to know who the hell won today. And the last time we did this, we brought Serenity on board, singer of passing time. She's wearing like a librarian in a turtleneck tonight, not looking like herself at all. I woke her up out of bed. She wasn't going to be on the show. She's like, no, I'm tired. I'm sleeping. I got to work in the morning. There's been upsets all over the place. The last time there was an upset this big, it was called the Titanic, and it sunk. The entire system has been upended, and I told her she had to be on. So, Serenity, come on in. Oh my God, what do you think of the results that we have seen today? No horsing around at all. What do you think of the madness that we have seen today?
Well, just waking up, don't really know much. You might have to tell me about it.
Oh, I'm gonna tell you, all right. Arizona went totally in Trump's favor. As a matter of fact, Trump, 244,922, he got 47.1% of the vote, and he got 58 delegates. Now, Arizona's Serenity is a winner-take-all state. That means he gets how many delegates? No, all of them. You went the wrong way. 58 delegates.
Told you, I just woke up.
Cruz got 127,682 votes, got 24.6% of the votes. Yeah, he got the golden goose egg. And Kasich, well, you know, Kasich Serenity, he got 53,032 votes, 10%. Now, how many delegates did Cruz get? Excuse me, Kasich get?
Kasich? Zero.
That golden freaking goose egg. Clinton, no surprise here, 230,566 votes, 57.9%. Now, the way the Democrats do it, this is strange. It's a winner-take-all state for the Republicans with delegates, but it isn't for the Democrats. Hillary gets 41 delegates at 57.9%. Sanders, 157,732, 39.6% of the vote. How many delegates did he get?
22.
Yes, he did. Now, this is where things get weird. This is why Serenity woke up. Utah, what the hell is going on in Utah? Cruz, 99,454 votes. He got 40 delegates. He destroyed Kasich, who got 24,329, 16.9% of the votes. How many delegates did he get?
Zero.
For the first time during the entire election cycle, Donald Trump is either taken first or second. This is the first time he has taken third. Trump, 20,477. Kasich beat him by 4,000 votes. Cruz beat him by 70,000 votes. 14.2% for Trump. What the hell is wrong with you in Utah? You want to make America suck again? No wonder nobody wants to be Mormon. Not allowed to say that, am I? Did I say that out loud?
I think you did.
As somebody that goes on stage with me, are you surprised?
Nope, not at all.
No, my old singer, my asylum, in Jaws of Victory said, you give Sam a mic and you hope for the best. You just cringe. Trump got his ass handed to him in Utah. Could we hear that again? Now, there's been another upset, and I'm smiling this time. Sanders! Bernie, give it to me free, even though we're a bankrupt nation. Sanders, 17,104 votes, 76.6%. Bernie Sanders gets 18 delegates. Clinton, 5,102. That is 12,000 more votes than Hillary Clinton. She got 5 delegates. Is that a shellacking?
I would say so.
All right, now Idaho.
The numbers are there.
Mrs. Clinton said.
There.
I don't know if you know this, but it's true. Allegedly, it's true. Mrs. Clinton said, yo, Idaho. Well, Idaho said she wasn't the hoe. She got 5,065 votes, but Sanders, you might be the hoe, but Sanders, yo, is the pip. 18,640, 78% of the votes, 17 delegates, Clinton got 5. Now, if you're watching this and you wonder if I've lost my mind because I'm rooting for Sanders, I'm actually, in this election, rooting for either Trump or Johnson. However, is it not wonderful when Mrs. Clinton gets beaten by anybody? She got schlacked. There's going to be an issue here, all jokes aside. What do you think of this? Hillary has the momentum to be the nominee. However, if she gets selected, and she probably is, if she gets selected over Sanders, Sanders supporters are not going to go to Hillary any more than Trump supporters are going to go to Cruz if they take it off Cruz. If you were in Hillary Clinton's camp right now, do you think you could pick a strong VP, or would you try to be kissing Sanders right now?
She better buy a lot of chapstick.
Yeah, Colonel Sanders maybe. And Sanders is older, so he's not probably going to be running again. So, I mean, this is do or die for him. Very interesting news. Serenity, you're welcome to stay. I don't know how much of this she has seen. Steve Watson, Prison Planet. Trump says the Islamic terrorists have turned magical places into cities of fear, armed camps. Now, I don't know if you're listening to this. I don't know if even Serenity knows this. But there are places in London, Brussels, throughout the European Union, as I destroy my own set, where the police won't go because it is so bad for people who are non-Muslim that they get attacked and beaten if they go there. That includes the police. Well, are you surprised to find out that the Brussels terrorist attack, of which the scum that is ISIS said they killed 200 people, thankfully they didn't. The current number here at 4:14 in the morning, to the best of my knowledge, stands at 34. Unfortunately, I'm pretty sure that's probably gone up as I go live here. I'm running screen share for low def. Do you think it's a good idea to have a no-go zone? Just, you know, they're Muslims and they're peaceful, so we won't raid them. They won't even go and look at them. And here's what's weird. If your son or daughter goes down the street to sell pot and they, like an idiot, decide to text it, they're going to get a criminal record, aren't they, if the police find it? But if they live in a Muslim community, it's not politically correct to go after the Muslims. So we won't even look there. You know, they built a bomb in a flat in an area that the police were afraid to go to in Brussels, Belgium. Belgium, home of Front 242. And if you don't know what that is, go look up Front 242 as soon as you're done with this show. Not a moment before it. You're going to love them.
Very awesome band.
Oh, my God. In the wake of the latest terrorist attacks in Europe, GOP frontrunner Donald Trump has correctly called for shoring up U.S. borders in an effort not to let beautiful cities become havens for Islamic terrorists. Now, Serenity, help me if this is racist at all, but I don't want to be blown up by a Muslim. Is that bad?
I don't think so. It could be portrayed as being bad.
Or come to think of it, you know, I don't want to be blown up by a black man.
No, that might be a little racist.
That's racist.
That might be a little racist.
You know, I don't want to be blown up by a white mutt like myself.
Oh, now you're just discriminating against your own kind.
I'm full of hate. All right, friends, listen. If you don't have some humor and you report on this, you just die. But unfortunately, let's be real. 34 people died today. And we try to keep a lighthearted show, but sometimes you got to be real. Listen to this. Speaking with Fox and Friends, Trump described how Brussels, the latest city to be attacked, has gone from one of the best places in the world to a hub for violent extremists. Brussels was an absolutely crime-free city, one of the most beautiful cities in the world, Trump said, adding, it is a magical place, and now it is an armed camp. You want to lead your life, you don't want to be living in an armed camp your whole life, and there is a certain group of people that is making living normal life impossible, said Donald Trump. And we've seen this in Paris. Look, friends, Donald Trump isn't the enemy here. I found out over the weekend that I lost a subscriber because I stuck up for Donald Trump. I was told that I'm now part of the establishment. That's absolutely hilarious to me because I'm just very happy that the establishment hates Trump. Would I have rather had Ron Paul, Gary Johnson, even Rand Paul? Yes. How did Rand Paul do? Okay, we don't have Rand Paul. Now, I'm somebody who my whole life has rallied against the woes of voting for the lesser of two evils. That's not what I'm doing when I'm voting for Trump. I don't think Trump is the second coming of Christ, but I don't think he's evil. I think he will put us in the right direction. Is he flawless? Absolutely not. He's crappy on the Fourth Amendment. How's he treat Snowden? Badly. He's wrong, okay? He's wrong on it. Waterboarding? He's wrong. You're going to waterboard the wrong person half the time. So, no, he's not a flawless man. But he's not an evil man. And I think he's going to be the jobs president. A little bit more on Brussels before we close out. We're going to do it quick today. Brussels attacks, video purporting to show Zaventem Airport explosion was shot in 2001. Now, Serenity didn't know I was going to go into this, but we're going to talk about it briefly. And it was Giselle, my fine correspondent in California, who agrees with me on nothing but is incredibly intelligent. Actually, that's not true. She agrees with me on a whole lot of things. She's just more left and I'm more right. But in terms of candidates, we never agree. She brought this to my attention. There are a large number of people who are saying that this was staged. Now, I know there are staged terrorist attacks, and I know that there are real terrorist attacks. One of two things happened here. Either CNN is deliberately planning these sorts of attacks, or not planning it, but knows about their planning ahead of time, or, and I'm going to be fair here, I'm not just trying to get clicks, you alphabetize things. And because Brussels was attacked once before, it would be listed alphabetically as Brussels. So it's possible to call up attacks from 2011 if you're a producer in a hurry and accidentally call up the wrong video. Those are the only two options we have here. This is interesting. CCTV purporting to show the deadly Brussels airport explosion appears to be fake. The footage resembles a video of the moment that a bomb attack took place on Domdivo Airport in Russia in 2011. So, looking back, there's a real good chance that this wasn't alphabetized as Brussels, since it looks like it was Russia now that I actually look at it. In the clip, which shows people walking before they duck and flee following an explosion, have been widely shared on social media since the blast took place on Tuesday morning. I'm going to go to screen share here. For those of you on a high def, I'm going to have Serenity move for just a second so that you can look at these. I'm not going to put my credibility out there and say that this was staged. I'm going to let you decide whether or not this was a production error or a purposeful error. But we're going to go ahead and look at this real quick. This is the Brussels Airport terrorist attack. You're finding it there on HDAF. Those of you on low def, you have it absolutely full-blown, and it's about a minute long. Now, this is the Brussels Airport attack, again, that you are seeing here. Take a good look at it, because we're going to compare it to the Russian attack. And again, you're not supposed to show things like this according to legend. So if you heard that, Serenity off camera, am I suicidal?
No.
Do I drive like I'm going to die? I'll probably get a ticket, but am I going to die?
No.
Okay, so if I suddenly die in a car crash or commit suicide, was it real?
No.
Good. And I'd also like to say that Serenity is not suicidal nor driving at all or crazy. Or I actually drink more than Serenity does.
For voice verification, no, I am not suicidal. So if it happens, no. You guys know it was set up.
Indeed. So there you go. There's a good look at the bombing that is purported to be in Brussels. Now, and the reason I'm showing this is so that other people can go ahead and compare these themselves. Here is the terrorist attack in Russia. There you go. Now, don't just go by the fact that it's black and white. Let's be fair. Is it the same footage? Or is it appearing to be the same footage? Well, I can't answer the question, but I can tell you this. I see a lot of people who are going to be able to recognize, especially with that zoom there, family members. Are these your family members that were in Russia in 2011? Or are these your family members that were in Brussels yesterday? I can't answer that question for you. I can ask those questions, but I cannot put my credibility on the line for a what if. It is damn possible. It really, really is. So I have given you the facts here. Do what you want. Look at those. Leave your comments. Let me know what you think. Share this widely. Ask these questions. Hey, friends, definitely, definitely ask these questions. In closing, if you want to be in this Serenity, I have recently been told that I'm part of the establishment now because I support Donald Trump. All right. If you don't support Donald Trump, let me let you into something. There's ways to go that do not involve voting for Hillary Clinton. Libertarians. What did you think of Gary Johnson?
I liked him, but I believe I was with Christelle in pinning in Ron Paul, but would have voted for him.
Two people that pinned in Ron Paul. Gary Johnson, I went to his rally. It's posted on the Correct Views. Type in the Correct Views, Gary Johnson. Gary Johnson was an excellent candidate. He was a two-term governor in Mexico that was pretty much forced out of the Republican Party because he wouldn't get any airtime during the last elections. So, he ran as a libertarian. Now, a great mystery exists here because he was polling at 10% a couple of days before the election in Ohio. He didn't have a sex scandal. He didn't have any weird scandal. He got 1% of the vote. Now, Serenity, how do you lose 9% of your votes in a day or two without having a scandal come out? Number of scandals associated with Gary Johnson is none. So, there's questions as to why he didn't get more votes. Was he going to win? No. But he was looking to get federal matching funds for the Libertarian Party, with which you need to hit 5% to. And he came in at 1%. But in Ohio, he was pulling a 10. So there are weird things going on. People have hinted that they are doing everything they can to keep the Libertarian Party at under 5%. Now, if you can get the Libertarian candidate to 5%, just 5% nationally, that's it, they will get federal matching funds. and quite likely be a member of the debates the following presidential cycle. So don't tell me that voting for a third party doesn't count, because it does count. If you can actually get a Libertarian up to 5% of the votes, then amazing things could happen. There could be a third party shakeup that we haven't seen since Ross Perot barely lost before. And this is something important. So, running against Gary Johnson, I'm going to go screen share, for the Libertarians, running against him this cycle is John McAfee. Now, my concern here is this. Did you ever run a McAfee virus killer Serenity that worked?
Not that worked.
No, whenever you ran McAfee, you usually got a virus that AVG would have to fix. You'd have to give your computer the bullet. However, he was the inventor of the virus killer. And he's one of the most computer literate minds that are extant today in the world. I'm interested to hear what his other policies and beliefs are, apart from computering, because McAfee may make a very interesting president. And I'm going to go in a bit here. For those of you that don't know, the government is harassing Apple to get a backdoor into their iPhone. They have refused. So, I'm not horsing around at all. McAfee has went ahead and been saying there are ways to do this that do not jeopardize the operating system, but will give you the facts you need regarding the slaughter that happened in San Bernardino. Well, according to Yahoo.com, John McAfee said he's not the third party helping unlock an iPhone used by a terrorist, but he knows who is, and he's not fond of their approach. In other words, it's been rumored that John McAfee was going to be the one to break into this phone because he had petitioned the government to do it. The government turned John McAfee down, and of course the government trusts him, they know him, he's running for president, it's not like he's going to lie to them. You're not going to jeopardize your entire career to lie about a terrorist. That's not going to happen. Well, it says, I promise you that Apple CEO Tim Cook and Apple are not going to be happy with the solution that the FBI has come up with. Says McAfee, the controversial technology executive, he told CNBC's Power Lunch, because it's almost as bad as a universal master key. In other words, the FBI is about to hack the iPhone in such a way that allows the iPhone to quite possibly be hacked by everyone. Whereas John McAfee, with his knowledge, was going to hack the phone, but not tell the government how he did it. Guess which option the government took? This is why, friends, if you hate Trump, you know what? Fine. Give him the one-finger salute and vote third party. Vote for Gary Johnson or John McAfee. I'm giving you a whole update on John McAfee right now, and I guarantee you're not going to get it anywhere else. He is the cybersecurity pioneer behind McAfee security antivirus software products. Now part of the Intel company, INTC for you stockbrokers, he declined the name with whom or how the FBI plans to move forward, but his comments come as the Justice Department says that it may have found a third party to hack the iPhone at the center of the cybersecurity standoff. McAfee has publicly petitioned the FBI to let him hack an iPhone used by a shooter in a deadly December terrorist attack in San Bernardino. And Apple, the maker of the iPhone, has so far refused, saying that the master key creates cybersecurity threats to other iPhone users, and the government has overstepped the boundaries of the law. Now, maybe Apple's to blame here, but can you please tell me why Apple or the government didn't trust John McAfee? It makes no sense. If John McAfee was to leak this, then you would say, hey, America, don't vote for this idiot. He can't even keep one secret on a phone that he promised. He has no credibility. And the Libertarians would do even bad and worse than they did last cycle, wouldn't they? You know, how would his credibility be?
It would be really bad.
So he's not going to lie. He's running for president. But no, no, you can't pick him to do it. It goes on, a hearing between Apple and the FBI set for Tuesday afternoon was postponed late Monday because the government needed to make sure that this third party can do it. If it can, then they won't be suing Apple. He said it's much, much easier to break into a phone using the technique that McAfee has, but he's not fond of the way that they're going to do it. To be sure, McAfee is renowned as much for his cybersecurity knowledge as for his exploits, including facetious comments to the press and his run-ins with the Belize, driving under the influence in Royal Tennessee. So basically, he got a DUI and they're trying to slander the man. Never mind the fact that the DUI laws in this country are so bad that you can get a DUI for having two shots. If you weigh 300 pounds! McAfee was critical of the efforts of the U.S. and its allies for tracking terrorist communications. Well, let me tell you what, we elected Obama and Bush, and they both snorted coke, so I think that's the least of our worries. The good thing is, this man knows something about computer encryption. He knows something about computer technologies. We had North Korea hack us. We had China hack us. This might prevent a lot of that. McAfee described a specific device that he would use that intercepts phone calls, tracks keystrokes before they are encrypted, which would make it impossible for ISIS to use encrypted messages if it catches it from the time it's on the computer to the time that it's typed. Such a device would make monitoring terrorists trivial, he said. He says, but right now we don't have a coherent strategy. We're looking for terrorists here in America, and by the time it happens, it's too late. So McAfee has created a device that, and he's a libertarian, so with a court order, with reason to, you can't just look at, what porn do you look at, Serenity? You can't just find out. Now, if they think she's looking up bombing, you don't look at bombing anybody, are you?
Never know.
If they suspect her of wanting to bomb somebody, now they can look. Again, I'm being silly, but what he's saying is, you give me a court order, and I'll be able to spy on anybody you want. I'm not going to spy on everybody all willy-nilly, but I'm going to spy on who I need to and get the job done. That's your John McAfee update. That's your election update. I will say this. Look into what he believes, because what worries me most about John McAfee is everything we see on him is computer-related. What's his stance on... Yeah, I mean, he's libertarian, so you can kind of guess he's anti-interventionist, anti-tax. Point is, I would like to hear him speak on these things. Where does he stand on ISIS? Some libertarians are in favor of attacking ISIS because they are affecting our interests. Some libertarians are not. Where's he? We need to know. So I'm looking forward to that debate, which will be happening in May. And that's your update. If you like Serenity and you want her to wake up again, then you're going to have to make sure you leave a comment. Let us know you liked her on the show. We'll make sure you get her again. You got your update. I hate Trump. Sam's a sellout. Fine. Share the video. I just gave you a huge update on McAfee, much bigger than you're going to find anywhere else online. Please donate at thecorrectviews@hotmail.com because I need your money. All this shit costs a lot of money. Good night, friends. God bless.